गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम यू ऑल वंस अगेन इन क्लास ऑफ इंग्लिश. दिस वीक वी आर लर्निंग अ पोएम बाय सरोजनी नायडू, वांडरिंग सिंगर्स. एंड दिस इज द थर्ड वीडियो. इन द लास्ट टू वीडियोज वी लर्न अबाउट द पोएम, अबाउट द पोएटेस सरोजनी नायडू, हर लाइफ, हर अचीवमेंट्स, her different creations, her activities and her appreciations in life. In another video, second video, I explained you whole poem line wise, stanza wise, and I'm sure that you must have learned everything, understood everything, and at the same time you must have written down all the things that is of great importance for you, not only for examination but to add your knowledge. So here in this third video session, this is the last video session of this poem, I am going to explain you the question answers that is in the exercise given, and there will be some more questions that I will discuss you in the class online. Let us see what is here in the exercise, that is understanding the poem. So proceeding to the first question, answer these questions. Which line tells you that the singers sing as they travel? You have to quote the line in your answer that tells that singers sing as they travel. Here that line is in third line of first stanza. With lutes in our hands, ever singing, we roam. This is the line in the poem that tells that the singers sing while they are traveling, while they are walking from one street to another, when they are traveling from one town to another, one village to another, one forest to other, they sing. They don't stop. Their singing is continue. So this is the line. With lutes in our hands, and lute, I have already explained you, lute is a musical instrument that was used in ancient times, even today also, but rarely. And in this instrument, musical instrument, there were strings. With the touch of the fingers in the string, there were very melodious sound produced. It was so melodious, so enchanting, so spellbound music. So it's clear here which line in the stanza in the poem tells that the singers sing as they travel, when they travel. Here question number two. The wandering singers have no permanent homes and families. Do they show any sadness about it, that they don't have any families? Or do they have a different notion of a family and home? Notion here means opinion. Their opinion. Do they have different opinion, different concept of family and home? This is the question. As the first question is asking, first part of the question asks you, the wandering singers have no permanent homes and families. Do they show any sadness or about it? So although the wandering singers do not have any permanent home or family, they do not show any sadness or regret for this. They don't have permanent house so that they can come back, stay and rest in that house, and they don't have any family, specific family, particular family for them, and for that they don't have any kind of regret, any kind of sadness, any kind of grief. These people, means wandering singers, believe that all human beings are their family members and whole world is their home, not any specific town, village or country, but entire world. They make no difference among humans, and they don't think that this is their country and that is not their land or country. So they don't feel any regret, any sadness, any grief for them. These people believe that all human beings are their family members and whole world is their home. These wandering singers do not make any difference among humans or lands. It's very clear, I think. You must have understood why they are not sad, okay, for any such thing that they don't have their families, they don't have their home. Not at all, because their notion is different about family. Their opinion is different. They think all human beings are their brothers, sisters, their friends, their own kinders, own relatives. And this is the reason that they do not stay at one particular place. They are not emotionally attached with any specific people, particular people or particular place. They roam and roam and continue to roam singing songs. Question next is here. What do the wandering singers sing about? What is the content about their song? What do the wandering singers sing about? And what might their listeners get from their songs in terms of knowledge when the listeners listen their song? What do they get as a knowledge and about the mood? Both. In both terms, we have to explain. So let us see first here. That is what here. What do the wandering singers sing about? The wandering singers sing about glory of old cities. As I explained you in the poem, and the stanza is very clear. These singers, wandering singers, sing about the ancient cities. Those cities whose beauty, whose glory is distinct, and which were great and famous. Those cities were great and very famous cities. We cannot really understand the beauty of that cities, ancient cities, that was in the past. And these singers are singing about those old cities, ancient cities, about the laughter and beauty of women. They also sing about the innocent laughter and the beauty of women who died long ago. They all died long ago, whose beauty and whose laughter were so enchanting. They also sing about old battles which were fought in the past, and kings, and of different happy, simple and sad things. They also sing about the past war battles which were fought in the history. They sing in the just memory of those great heroes who died in the war, in the battles. They sing about the great kings, their heroic deeds, and their song contains some happy, simple and sad things, sad contents, every content. So their song content several things of life, related to life, related to the philosophy of life: happiness, sadness, joy, separation, beauty, everything. I'm sure you must have understood. Now we have to really answer, what might their listeners get from their songs in terms of knowledge and mood? So let us now here see just term wise. First knowledge and then mood. In terms of knowledge, listeners can learn something of history as they are singing about the past and glorious cities, about the past battles, kings. So listeners can learn something of history and folklore from the wandering singers as they sing of cities, battles, women and kings of past. So these are the sources of knowledge, and the listeners can no doubt get the knowledge about all this. Next, that is in terms of mood. So in terms of mood, the listeners can feel fascination, curiosity, admiration, sadness, and excitement as they hear about glorious beauty of women and their happiness, battles that were bravely fought, and kings. These things are what are of great values, and so the songs really inspire and changes the mood of the listeners in the fascination, bringing curiosity, admiration about those people, about the beauty, then sadness about the heroic deeds of the soldiers or the kings, past kings, those who died in the battle, and excitement as they hear about the cities, about the kings, about the battle, about the beauty of women. Let's hear more to the fourth question. Question number four is, why do wandering singers not wait anywhere? Clear. Question is very clear. Why do wandering singers not wait anywhere? And why do they keep traveling? You have your answer. The wandering singers do not wait anywhere because no specific bond or emotional relationship make them or force them to stay on at any particular place their happiness is not associated with a particular place or people where they might wait. The free movement of the wind call them to follow it. The sound of the wind feels like the voice of singers. Here, these were the questions from your understanding the poem, and I will have some more questions, students, from the poem that I will discuss in the class. So you will write down these question answers in your copy, you learn them. Thank you, students, thank you very much being with me.